After a commitment to build Connecticut into a biotech corridor, the plan is coming to fruition just ahead of Labor Day weekend. News 8 anchor Scott McDonald shows us how one of those companies that moved into the state is now adding 8 to 10 jobs a month. Here's tonight's closer look.
We are looking for the best and the brightest from anywhere on the planet.
At their stunning new facilities in Farmington, Jackson Laboratories is on the cutting edge of research.
Many diseases are caused by changes in the cellular makeup of the individual, their DNA.
Scientists looking at anomalies and mutations in human genes and using that information to help fight disease.
So we find out the problem genes and experiment with ways to modify them so that people become healthy again.
The DNA double helix visible all through the workplace, a new way to work, open spaces, places to bring a laptop and sit, interact, the informal way scientific discovery happens.
Where did you first get your inspiration? More often than not, they'll say, well, I was at the coffee bar and I was talking to my colleague.
It's a more comfortable way to work for millennials, and Jackson Labs is one Connecticut company looking to hire plenty.
We've been open for just about 5 years now since we first signed our deal with the state of Connecticut, and we're closing in on 250 employees. Right now, today, we have 56 vacancies listed at our HR office.
Right now, adding on 8 to 10 employees a month.
They pay very well. On average, people here earn about double the statewide average.
The Jackson Laboratory story, part of a larger one, Connecticut's biotech growth and investment coming to fruition.
And that's what this whole investment was really about. Create the intellectual capital, the inventions, the patented processes and discoveries on which you can build an industry.
In Farmington, Scott McDonald, News 8.